Good afternoon. I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Dan Schultz, and I'm from Flemington, New Jersey. Thank you for taking the time out of your summer to be here today and prepare to move forward together. I'm sure many of you are finding out about your fall schedules right now with some kind of online teaching element involved. My school district is running live classes at reduced capacity, but I don't know what that means yet. We have a hybrid of live and online learning, and I'm not quite sure of any of the specifics just yet. I'm here to help with offering a few ideas for middle school general music, but hopefully some of this crosses over into any area of music teaching. I'm extremely grateful for Music First stepping up in a huge way during the physical shutdown from March through June, and also stepping up by offering this free training at no cost this summer. Just a brief bit of background about me. In addition to being a band and orchestra teacher for 32 years, I've taught general music for two decades concurrently in the J.P. Case Middle School with 7th and 8th grade. I teach in a regional K through 8 district, and our students are sent to a large regional high school in Hunterdon County. We're about 60 miles west of New York City, but it's surprisingly rural and very beautiful. For me, general music is interpreted as music for the general student. Our curriculum is very comprehensive under normal circumstances, but these are not normal circumstances. We normally have organic music making with guitars and bucket drums, and a fair degree of academic rigor with historical and cultural studies. The student is also placed with an emphasis on using technology and music creation, and we use programs like Note Flight, we use Soundation, we use O-Generator, and a few other programs offered by Music First. Regardless of a student's background, we have a student who might be interested in music and might participate in band, chorus, or orchestra, or it could be somebody who hasn't had a music class since elementary school and they haven't had an interest in music. But either way, we want them walking away from our class saying, "What did I enjoy from Mr. Schultz's class?" In addition to teaching online, I'm asking myself, what are the more engaging lessons that I'm teaching online with kids? In middle school, some of the lessons work great one day, and the next day they fall a little bit short. I'm sure you understand how that goes. We'll take a deeper dive into some of the specifics about what I do in my program next. During today's time frame, I'm not going to attempt to explain my entire curriculum, but give you a few options which I've created and taught before, as well as spotlight some of the content already created by an exceptional small army of music educators who write and share lessons within Music First. The strength of the Music First platform is the collective number of lessons on a wide range of materials which you can customize for your own needs. I have one minor technical disclaimer. My district is a Google Classroom district, and we use it as our primary hub for learners in grades K through 8. So you'll see a number of assignments that germinate in Google Classroom, but link to Music First. Whatever your school uses, it would likely operate in the same manner that I use, by linking the assignments. I wouldn't get bogged down by any fear of integration compatibility. So let's get started with an easy assignment that I call Introduce Yourself. It's a one-button recording task that's very simple to start out with. This past term during the COVID-19 shutdown, I met my general music class for the first time online. Many of the students I had never met before and didn't know. Some of the students were in my orchestra class, and some of the students I knew from being in band and chorus just from around the hallways. But the first thing I like to do in general music is get to know the students, and this is an introduce yourself recording using a simple one-button, red button recorder that's provided in Music First, and the students would link to a script that they created in Google Docs and read from that script and put some of the information into their recording. So the script would look like this. It would say, "Hello, my name is..." In this case, we're going to hear from Duncan. Outside of school, what are their different interests and what's their music background? Who are their favorite musical artists and what are their favorite songs in their playlist right now? So the student recording would sound something like this.
Hi, my name is Duncan. Outside of school, my favorite things to do are go to friends' houses and mountain bike. In music, I have played two instruments, the guitar and the recorder. This week, I feel relaxed during the school closure. My favorite musical artist is 21 Pilots. If you ask me what's on my favorite songs playlist right now, the top three songs would be Sunflower by Post Malone, Island in the Sun by Weezer, and Jumpsuit by 21 Pilots. I like these songs because they involve interesting mood changes and diverse types of music.
So let's go through the steps of creating a task similar to what I did in the Introduce Yourself task. Simply start by clicking on the plus sign to create a new task. Give your assignment a title. When you choose the task type, choose record audio. You can put in your descriptions there with a link to a Google document and assign yourself a date and time. Make sure it's visible to all students. You can set your standards then. In this case, it's more of a critique standard, and I usually add it to my online gradebook. Decide to give it a certain point value, and you can create a rubric and a grading description on clarity of reading. You can also add in if they filled in the content correctly, and then simply create your task. If you want to link it to Google Classroom, you've got a button to link to Google Classroom, and it will then link to Google Classroom automatically. And I want to encourage you to try something simple to start off your term with if you're going online from home.
It's important to acknowledge that with any classroom software or learning management system, there's going to be a learning curve for teachers as well as students. Keeping this in mind, I suggest that any teacher start out each term with at least one or two of the lessons in the Getting Started series. The Getting Started series is in the Music First content area, and it's a great idea to complete an easy task to allow the students to become familiar with the nuances of working in each software area. Another one-button recorder task, which students really enjoyed, was the parent or guardian interview project. I started this assignment in a Google form and then had the students record in a one-button recorder. It asked the students about their parents' favorite songs, what type of music devices they were played on when they were growing up, and what are their parents' favorite musical genres, as well as if their parent ever played a musical instrument in their teenage years. It asked them specifically, did their parents attend concerts, and what the parents current listen to in the car while driving alone. It's also good to relate to today's artists to see which of today's artists they listen to and enjoy, that they might share that enjoyment with their kids. Next, we'll take a look at OGenerator. OGenerator has been developed to provide a simple and engaging experience for all students. It particularly caters to those students who are required to have music lessons in school, but may not be instrumentalists or read music. In my experience, special needs students love using this software because of its accessibility and simplicity. Some of the special needs teachers in my building use this software when their students need a brain break from other classes. OGenerator is a software app in which is my go-to resource for having students create music in middle school without a great deal of experience, and we do this early in our term. Let's take a look at some of the lessons. One of the most accessible ways of getting to use OGenerator is to use Getting Started with OGenerator, which Jim Frankel created. The lesson can be copied, and it provides a good video resource for demonstrating for the students, as well as the lesson instructions that can be copied and opened up in Music First software. Let's take a look at a student composition. You can see 16 spokes representing 16th notes all in a wheel. The different layers represent instruments which can be changed or customized. The innermost layer is rock drums, followed by the orange layer of rock cymbals, and then in green we have a rock bass guitar, in blue we have a clean electric guitar, and in purple we have a funky electric piano with chords being played. There's four bars in this composition, and we have a play button at the center. Each of these pads can be clicked on and changed, and they're called padlets, and you can scroll through a number of different instruments. Let's listen to this composition. To me, the most interesting thing was the work that was done on the cymbals in the second layer. And this student has a drumming background, which leads to some really creative work here in that second layer. It's important to take advantage of a number of the tutorial videos that are under the question mark in your Music First platform. If you click on Tutorials and scroll down near the bottom, you'll find the student tutorials for O Generator. It's very helpful if you just play the videos and make sure you include links to these videos for your students.
All of your assignments will be listed on your class overview page. If you have an O Generator assignment, it'll look like this.
At the O Generator website, there are plenty of ideas for lessons, including a collaborative songwriting lesson, which would be great with classified learners or even to try with a class.
Welcome to our O Generator teaching zone. So this is a guide on how to teach the most popular O Generator lessons. So we have a number of whole class songwriting lessons. This one is a whole class collaboration in which students are encouraged to come out and complete or add to a song which is an O Generator. This is great because it allows you to combine literacy and music, and there's a 7-step guide on how to write your lyrics and how to perform. You can do this in your classroom. All you require is your laptop, Wi-Fi, your speakers and your projector. The music's all there and then you're away. So log in as normal and then on the front page select group lessons. Then select modern, green level. Then you'll need to choose your music. You can compose from dance, pop or rock. Once you've decided, start O Generator. Once you're inside O Generator, you go to the bottom right hand corner and just click on the flashing audio button. This is going to guide the students in terms of composing the song. They'll be encouraged to come out one at a time and create a melody line, add to the drums. Get the whole class involved in this. It's no problem if they delete or they change notes. The important thing, once you're happy with the song, then you can carry on using the audio button and it will guide them through the 7 steps to create the lyrics.
Other ideas for O Generator include creating rock drum patterns or rhythm section patterns or instrumental patterns. And the students can also create electronic dance music. One of the things that the students are able to do in O Generator is they are able to export their files and we can trim them in Soundation to become loops. If you click on the record button, it'll allow you to either sing with your loops or you can actually just record the loops that you have. And you press go to record, let it load. So OGenerator is a very exciting program to use. It's very accessible for your kids, and I hope you enjoy exploring it early on in your term when you're just getting to know your students and you just want to make some music ahead of any time of working on theory or working on some other historical projects. It's great to just engage the kids right away with this, so I do it very early in the term. Next up, we'll take a look at Soundation. Soundation is a fully functional, cloud-based digital audio workstation. Some refer to this as a DAW. In the production world, all types of digital media use DAWs. Cloud-based digital audio workstations offer the opportunity for mixing audio on a Chromebook or on a laptop computer. Soundation looks very similar to GarageBand with the exception of the color graphics, but it operates in the cloud across different platforms and devices. Our students have all district-issued Chromebooks, which all have recording microphones, which work quite well for fun projects like voice recording, voiceover commercials, podcast projects, and many other projects. Let's take a look at an example of a Soundation recording done on a recreation of the theme from the Netflix hit Stranger Things. The Soundation example was downloaded for free at the Soundation.com website with a group of recreated SNG files. The file can be downloaded as a .SNG file and then loaded into a blank Soundation file under the File menu. The reason I started with this clip is it demonstrates the use of drums, synthesizers, arpeggiators, bass, and sound effects. So it's fairly obvious that we wouldn't start off the school year recreating the Stranger Things theme in Soundation. It's best to start with a getting started task, or a voiceover commercial, or a top five personal countdown. And we'll take a look at some other options that are shared in Music First's shared content library. At the end of this past school year, several students were asked by our principal to record the Star Spangled Banner. We decided to use Soundation because they were recording at home and we could share the files. The piano accompaniment part was put in first. Our chorus teacher edited the project and then sent it to me, who did some additional editing, removing things like clipping and some extraneous noise in the background. I added effects to it and then sent the audio file ahead to another teacher who was putting together a video for the virtual promotion ceremony. For those of you who want to tackle an easier way to provide virtual showcases, mixing audio and Soundation may be exceptionally helpful. Here's a brief portion of our Star Spangled Banner. Before I hit the play button, take a look at the track with the name Quinn on it, and you can see where I edited out all the peaking, which is digital distortion that can't be removed from a file, so I just cut it out and it's covered by the other singers. Two easy lessons, a voiceover commercial, and a top five personal countdown, which work great in a general music setting. The voiceover commercial is an easy project which involves creating a radio-style commercial. I found a number of scripts that were online and that were royalty free, and I copied them into a Google document and provided them for the students. They're actually real advertising ads that were played on the radio in this area. I'm asking students to study their script, record their voice, and add some music and loops in the background. I asked the students to read and consider a few elements in their speaking, their pitch, their tone, their rhythm and pacing of the speech, as well as the clarity of pronouncing words and the ability to provide a meaningful accompaniment in the background with automated sound fading up and down. We go through some of the difficulties in speaking pitfalls, and I'd like to give you an example of one of my students reading her commercial.
Joy is timeless. Joy is a story that has no end. Every page is a milestone, every chapter a breakthrough. Innovation may be our backbone, but joy is the heart that carries on the BMW legacy, an ongoing tradition from the first car we ever made to our latest design. Joy is never ending. The story of joy continues at bmwusa.com/joy.
Another project example is a top five personal countdown where the students choose five songs that they really like to listen to, and they provide a dialogue for a radio style countdown, and they edit the songs in using a YouTube converter website. I ask the students to mention the song's name, the artist, the year of the release. Sometimes I ask the students to mention awards that the songs may have received, or any memories that they have related to the songs, or significant lyrics or musical grooves that you like. So here's an example of a student doing a top five Disney countdown.
Hi, my name is Brianna, and I will be telling you my top five favorite Disney songs. Coming in at number five is Be Our Guest from the movie Beauty and the Beast. It was released in 2005, and my favorite part of the lyrics to the song is when it says, be our guest, put our service to the test, tie your napkin round your neck, cherry, and we'll provide the rest. This song has been awarded the nominee ACCA Award.
Be our guest, be our guest, put our service to the test, tie your napkin round your neck, cherry, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre.
If you'd like students to complete historical and cultural projects, I can suggest a lesson that I created for the Intro to Jazz course, which includes material from the blues and the Great Migration, and especially if you have interests in teaching about the history behind much of today's social unrest. Soundation can be used for a number of different options, including a student's interpretation of a song or a study of the 12-bar blues song form. In terms of younger audiences, this might be a challenging topic, and please exercise some caution in examining the lyrics and music of the blues era. Some of the language is certainly different than today's language. These topics can be of great interest to eighth grade students, and I can suggest that students record narratives on guided questions where they respond to different musical cues within a song. So let's take a look at this unit. A few years ago, I came up with a course with 40 lessons on a history of jazz called Intro to Jazz. One of the lessons was called The Blues and the Great Migration. It might be a really good time to revisit some of these lessons and see how we can use them in context of today's social unrest and looking at the history behind it going all the way back to the Reconstruction era. One of the songs that I referenced in this lesson is Avalon Blues, and it may be good to take a look at the song and explore the song's meaning and feelings that are behind it as Mississippi John Hurt sings about his homesick feelings of leaving Mississippi and coming to New York City. A number of student projects could involve possibly creating a narrative where the student responds about their feelings, what they think about in listening to the song, or what they think that the composer might have been feeling as he wrote the song and expressed it in this recording. If you'd like to look specifically at production-based lessons in Soundation, take a look at Stephanie Wagon's Soundation Lessons, which is a 10-lesson unit which goes over specifics of how to use soundation in smaller chunks, and it has a great lesson on form. Once I've moved to more intermediate and advanced lessons with my kids in soundation, one of the challenges that I came up with was to create a composition using Epic Online Orchestra and then exporting that into Soundation. I'm going to play the introduction video for you that explains how to use Epic Online Orchestra with Soundation that I provided for my students back in April. Hey class, it's Mr. Schultz coming to you here from home, and I wanted to introduce you to Epic Online Orchestra. This might be really helpful later on when we do a project where we are trying to make a sound design for a short video. And this has some orchestral sounds, which might be something that you hear in the background in movie scoring. So if you've ever watched something like Star Wars, it's the orchestra that plays in the background that really makes some of the scenes very, very dramatic, besides all the great video and storyline. So the Epic Online Orchestra will be linked in your music, in your Google Classroom. And across the top, it says play chords. And we've got 7 major chords and 7 minor chords, which would be equivalent to the starting on the white keys on the piano. There's an advanced mode where we would have the white keys and the black keys. And so you'd have a full chromatic scale option there. But we're going to keep it in simple mode right now. And then across the bottom, they have some sequenced chords that they put together for you, which also play. One of the ways I like to explain this is in the major chords, think of the major chords as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And we might notate these in Roman numerals if I was writing this down. And then we've got minor 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So that's just a little bit of music theory. When you make a chord progression, if you went 1-4-5-1, it would sound like this. 1-4-5-1. Then, and those are all major. And if I went 1-2-4-5-6, it'll sound like this. And that might sound a lot like church music. Then we've got some other things across the bottom. Let's play Sadness. Oh, let's do Outer Space. And then maybe we'll do some of our own examples. I'm going to clear the chord out and go. And I'm going to play those now. It's playing those at 100 beats per minute. And I'm going to export that now. I'm going to export it as a MIDI file, and you'll see why in a moment. I'm going to drag it to my desktop. It might be in your downloads folder on your Chromebooks. And then I'm going to open up a file. And I'm going to put it at 100 beats per minute. And I'm going to delete this file that's here already. So we're going to make this work in time. Drag and drop my little chord progression, and we know that this plays at 100, so I'm going to drag and drop a drum pattern that works well. Let's give this a listen.
fairly cool.
We can change that sound from simple synth to the orchestra sounds if we wanted it to be. So let's go orchestral sounds. Let's see what that sounds like now. And then you are free to add some other grooves to it. Remember to use time stretch if you're taking something from a different tempo. Let's see what this sounds like. And that riff didn't work all that well, but it might, if we check out some of these other ones, we might find some that work really. Here's an example of what a student did using Epic Online Orchestra and then exporting into Soundation. Hope you enjoy it. Epic Online Orchestra was a lot of fun to work with. The students responded very positively with it, and it's a great program to experiment with and see where it can go in using it with Soundation. For further lessons in discovering ideas about technology, check out Dr. Scott Watson's Using Technology to Unlock Creativity. It's a sample lesson, and then there's also premium content available in the shared content area. Dr. Scott Watson has been a teacher in the Allentown, Pennsylvania area for a long time and has done a great job with training other teachers as well as teaching his students at an exceptionally high level. So check that out. Next up, we'll have some lessons in note flight. In terms of teaching music online, note flight offers the easiest entry-level opportunity for the students. Once you've reviewed the basics of music notation reading, including pitch reading and rhythm reading, having students create music offers them one of the best opportunities to develop their higher order thinking skills, synthesizing all of the skills and information we've learned about in music. Before we continue, just a few words about troubleshooting and lesson creating. The Getting Started lesson series will help the student and the teacher get accustomed to how to open a template file, as well as linking the files to the Music First classroom. These skills do take some time to acquire in lesson creating and are often a source of frustration for students and teachers if the lessons are not linked correctly. Reviewing the Help tutorial series for teachers and students is essential under the question mark icon in your Music First classroom screen. Troubleshooting tech problems could be an entire presentation of its own. When in doubt, email support at Music First and take screenshots or videos of your screen to demonstrate if you have any issues. In the shared content library within Music First, I've created two lesson units which were shared. One's called Kid-Friendly Note Flight Composition, and the other is called Beginner Note Flight Composition Lessons for Middle School and High School. There's 7 lessons and 15 tasks in each. Let's take a look at some of these lessons. This composition unit uses note flight to attempt to match the process of trying to think in sound for younger musicians while learning constructive practices common in reading music notation. Without a doubt, traditional music notation is a practical device for the transfer of musical ideas from one person to another. The purpose of this unit is to gain a creative foothold toward creating music. The goal for middle school students should be to allow freedom to create unique, personal, and emotional compositions, and not necessarily have it sound correct to the conservatory-trained ear. Students should strive to create compositions which have purpose and are meaningful to them. Thinking in sound is challenging. Encourage your kids to write practical and useful music while allowing for variety. Seek out visual images to inspire creative thinking, as well as listening examples beyond the scope of what are mentioned in these lessons. There are some time-tested methods which help compositions to develop, like developing motives and using theme and variation. It's never a bad idea to listen to Mozart's variation on Twinkle Twinkle Little Star for piano. A motive becomes the cornerstone for a composition. Once a good motive is constructed, it can be manipulated in different ways to write a good melody and add interest. Some of the ways to manipulate a melody include repetition, sequence, inversion, retrograde, retrograde inversion, diminution, augmentation, and variation. We can take a look at these specifically in this lesson. So in lesson two, compose a melody with motive and note flight, we're going to take a look at a familiar melody, Merrily We Roll Along, and in the first task, we're going to compose the melodic line backwards from its original form. And then in the second task, you're going to explore using a sequence or repeating notes on a different pitch level. In the third example, we can take the idea and make the rhythmic motives smaller by reducing the rhythmic value, possibly by half, and then repeating them. In the fourth variation, we're going to create our own variation, an original motive of your own, and explore the development of the motive using several of the techniques mentioned. At this point, click on Open in Note Flight, and your lesson should load, and this allows the student to get started in rhythmic diminution and augmentation. Have fun with the process, and when you're done, one possible idea is to export the music going to the score menu, and you can export as a MIDI file, drag the file into Soundation, and add loops to it to have a creative beat or background to it. Have fun with the process. I highly recommend purchasing the premium content for Inside Music, which includes 27 well-written lessons with great videos for instruction. Let's take a look at the first lesson. The first lesson, Building a Melody, goes over steps, skips, and leaps in great detail and provides three compositional exercises along with three reflections. Diana York is the host and lays out great examples for the kids to listen to.
Hello, I'm Diana York, and welcome to Inside Music, your guide to exploring music composition. Today we're going to start you on the path to composing your own music with our first lesson, Building a Melody. When you think about your favorite pieces or songs to listen to, which part of the song comes to mind? Chances are you remember the melody first. When a song gets stuck in your head, which part do you find yourself singing over and over? Again, the answer is probably the melody. Of course, there are other important parts of music, the bass line, the rhythm, the harmony, the instruments that are playing, and much more. We begin with melody because it's the heart of most music. The first thing to keep in mind is that a melody is like a journey. It could be a long journey across many countries, or a short journey down the block. Regardless of how long or short, our journey must end with a return home. Musically, this means our melodies should end on the home tone, so they feel resolved and final. As listeners, we always want the music to return home. Let's start by listening to one of the greatest themes in musical history.
There are literally hundreds of lessons in the Music First shared content library, and I want to highlight Shauna Longo's popular music course, as well as March Lopresti's music theory course, as both extensive courses that are great for middle school kids. In addition, I've mentioned the Introduction to Jazz course that I created, and I want to leave you with one last project that I worked on. It's a stop-motion animation project that was created largely outside of Music First. This involves using an iOS app, and we used shared iPads in our classroom, and we used a premium app called MyCreate that allowed students to do stop-motion animation. The students also created a soundscape in Soundation by creating background sounds, and they mixed in WeVideo and GarageBand. The project was focused on trying to create a 30-second project to highlight a local charity which tries to make the world a better place. The outline of the lesson is here.
Just like our friend Ryan, you too gonna help out the Flemington Food Pantry at one of our convenient drop-off boxes in the Flemington ShopRite and the Flemington Stop and Shop.
You may also donate non-perishable food items at the pantry during normal business hours.
I would be remiss if I didn't mention some additional resources available from Music First. Check out InTune Monthly Magazine. There's great articles for kids to read about things like how to form a band. And also check out Shed the Music, which is an online resource from Bob Habersat that is just wonderful. It's got some great production resources with it, as well as things like band courses that would be great for your instrumentalists. Also, Maud Hickey's Music Outside the Lines is a super guide for anyone who's teaching composition. There's wonderful ideas with that. And there's also wonderful resources like soundgirl.org, which recently had an article featuring Alexandra Perryman, who is a NASA sound engineer. And there's a great article right up on her, which would be a great reflection article for kids in your class. I also want to give thanks to the staff at Music First. And Rachel LaRue has been wonderful in helping get prepared for this conference, as well as the everyday help from Juliana Mateko and all the good people at Music First. There will be some web links provided for you so that if you want to catch up with some of these websites, we'll put it on a PDF for you. Thank you so much, and I will be in the chat room for questions and answers with whatever you need.